Hey guys, in this video, we learn about a few different types of sets, as well as what we mean by the terms equal or equivalent sets. Let us begin with the empty set. An empty set is a set containing no elements. It is also known as a null set or a void set. We denote an empty set by phi or a pair of curly braces. An example of an empty set would be a set of vowels in the word sky. Now there are no vowels in the word sky, and so there is no element in this set. What we have is an empty set. Here's another example. Look at the description of the set B. X such that X is a natural number, and X lies between 2 and 3. Again, there are no natural numbers between 2 and 3. And so again, we end up with an empty set. Next, we have the singleton set. This is a set with exactly one element. Here are two examples of singleton sets. The set A has only one element, which is 0. B is a set of natural numbers between 2 and 4. There is only one such number, 3. So, B also has only one element and hence is a singleton set. A finite set. If the number of elements in a set is limited or finite, the set is a finite set. If you look at the examples, set A has 2 elements and B has 13 elements, natural numbers from 2 to 14, both included. And so both A and B are finite sets. If a set has an indefinitely large number of elements, it is called an infinite set. Here, A is a set of whole numbers and so does not have a finite number of elements. You start with 0 and then just keep on counting forward. The numbers never end. Something similar happens in set B. It is a set of natural numbers greater than 15. Again, there is an indefinitely large number of natural numbers greater than 15. So, A and B are both examples of infinite sets. Okay, now let us move to two very important concepts, the concepts of equal and equivalent sets. Equal sets. Two sets are said to be equal if they have exactly the same elements. Now remember, order of elements inside a set is immaterial. So, as long as the elements are the same, the sets are equal. Here, we see that the two sets in the example are equal. Now before we move ahead, let me introduce to you the concept of cardinality or cardinal number of a set. The number of distinct elements in a finite set is known as the cardinal number of the set. We denote it using either of the two ways that you can see here. It is read as the number of elements of the set A. It's a very easy and simple concept. Here you can see in the examples. A has 4 elements and so the cardinal number of the set A is 4. B has 6 elements and so its cardinal number is 6. Cardinality of the empty set is 0. Cardinal numbers are defined only for finite sets because in an infinite set, the number of elements is indefinite. Alright, now let's go back to our original discussion and look at equivalent sets. Two finite sets are said to be equivalent if they have the same number of elements. In other words, two sets are said to be equivalent if their cardinality or cardinal numbers are the same. Please note that in case of equivalent sets, the elements need not be the same. What we are concerned with is the number of elements. In our example, both sets A and B have 4 elements each and so they are equivalent. And thus we come to the end of this video. Thank you for watching.